Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? I got the Kirovits working away out in the field, and for some reason, when I restarted the game just now, the twin wheels have disappeared. I'm not quite sure why, whether it's a bug or whether I hired them, I'm not actually certain. So, I don't really know what's happened with those. Anyway, he is working way out in the field. He's doing cultivating now. He did the ploughing. But it doesn't really matter. I asked you a question last week. Do you want me to continue this map for much longer? Do you want me to finish it up soon, a few weeks? Do you want me to run it until FS17 comes out? I had a very mixed response, I've got to be honest. But slightly ahead seemed to be either do a few more weeks or finish it up this week. So I have decided I'm going to finish it up this week. I know there's quite a few things that we wanted to do, etc, etc. We're not going to get to them all. The combine that we were going to get, the Rosselmash, I'm not actually going to get it this week. I have got that on the next map. The next map is ready to go. I'm going to go to Higher Hills. That is a little small map, which would be just perfect, I think, for running for a few weeks until we come to 17. So I've swapped the combine out on that one for the Rosselmash, so the old one that with the 9-meter header that everybody wanted. And I've also had quite a few requests to do this beekeeping mod. Let's just hop into the bulb for a minute, because we got half a pallet of cereal here that I had to take off to start with because it didn't seem to like it over there. So we're going to start driving this one up to where the wool is, so hopefully we can sell this at the same time. Because, you know, that's where we put our sell point. So I've got the Rosselmash on there. I've put the beekeeping mod. I've installed all of the bits and pieces for it. I've put two beehive makers, two beekeepers, and then one each of the two big structures, because we've only got one of them on this map. I put one each. I managed to find a flat space to put them. It was very difficult. It's not dead level, so we do have them slightly up in the air, but it was actually quite difficult trying to locate a flat area on that map. But I have done it. I have succeeded. So, as we're going on to Higher Hills, I've got that, and I've got a few other pieces in place so that we don't have to struggle and try and make a load of money. I'm going to run it on normal difficulty. I'm going to have withering turned off because most of the fields are ready to harvest already. So we want withering off or we're going to lose most of them. What else was I going to do? I'll run it on 5x speed as normal. The question I wanted to ask you... Oh, I'm also going to have... I think I'll have 100 cows on it already so that we can sort of start... get stuck straight into farming. So the question I want to ask you is, do you want me to go, so we'll sort of assume that we've sold this farm, you know, it's worked for a few years, we've sold the farm, we've sold the machinery, and we've got a few bits of new machinery, because it's new machinery that we'll be using, we won't go to old machinery again. Do you want me to start off with 100,000, it's in the UK, so it'll be pounds this time, £100,000, £150,000, or £200,000? So it's your vote, it's your game. Head down below, let me know what you want. Do you want me to start the next map with 100, 150 or £200,000 for buying machinery? Now, that one sells straight in there. 1,648. Is that all? I'm pretty sure we sold, all the cereal, the milk and everything else that has gone into that. I'm not sure that 1,648 is enough, but that wasn't a full pallet. Maybe we should try a trailer or something so we can put a few pallets on. I'm going to drive back a minute and get the next pallet because there's a pallet ready. And then there's a few of the bits and pieces on it are now empty. I'm not going to worry too much about that because we're going to do some spraying on this map before we go. So we've got a sprayer that's ready to roll. And we've got some baling that we need to do with a small baler so that we can try and put that in for the cows. We've got a bit of silage that's ready as well. We needed straw. To be honest, I'm not sure if we're not going to be able to get straw because we can't get it out of the oilseed rape or canola off to the side here. So we're not going to actually be able to make mixed rations. But I would at least like to do some baling and we can pick up the bales and have play around with them. There's a couple other little tasks that I wanted to get done. We'll see how it goes. That one's run out of water. So I'm just going to take this pallet and sell it. And then once we've done this one pallet, I'm not going to worry too much about the beekeeping mod, because I'm going to sort of focus a lot of my energies in the next map on running the beekeeping mod. I'm trying to keep everything full, keep it all going, because this is a really cool mod. And a lot of you have said that you're really enjoying this, you're liking me using it. And I did have a couple of requests to really go for it on Sandy Bay and like really do this on a big scale. I decided not to do it on Sandy Bay because there's a lot of other tasks I'd like to do on that map, so I'm going to do it on the higher hills one, and I just think that one would be perfectly suited for it. I haven't, I will also add, clumped everything together. I've spread it out around the map a bit, so there's going to have to be a sort of bit of moving back and forth in order to get everything in. I'm just going to drive up to the sale point again, and we'll see how much we get for this one. There we go. Just come in through here. Let's just have a look at this cereal. I haven't actually looked at it. Bee Cool Muesli. Okay. Cool Muesli. I'm not actually sure what cool... I think that's German again. Muesli is muesli, but cool, I'm not quite certain what that is. Now, how much are we going to get for a full pallet? 2,137 euros. I'm not altogether certain what has gone into that. I know we got the honey and you got the cereals. We'll drive down and we will just take a look at what has sort of gone in to make up that one pallet. And then what are we going to do then? We'll go and get the sprayer hooked up so that we can start doing a little bit of spraying on some of the cultivated fields. Right. I was just thinking on the way down. So we've only used... There's 5,400 for the milk. The honey is all gone. What have we got then? Cereals are at 45 and milk is at 45%. The honey has all been used up. That's not too bad, I suppose, because the cereals and the milk are obviously the ones that you get quite a bit of money out of. And this one here has got a tiny bit on the pallet. Over here, we've got... We've got no water left. I know that we got no water left because it came up with an alarm. 36% on beehives and honey. We've got 1,000 litres of honey in there. That's 6% on that tank. And then this one over here, this one is full. That's got the full 3,000, but it's used up all of the wood chips. They are now all gone. So I'm not going to worry about messing around with this one for now. We will come back to... We might come back to it on this map. I'm not quite certain, but we want to get onto this one. Yeah, on the way down here, I was thinking that perhaps we could do the baling before we do some spraying and do the spraying tomorrow, because I am really keen to have a go with that baler. I would really like to have a go with it. But as we've sort of got this here, I think, yeah, we'll go on and do this now. We'll do the spraying, try this one out. And then we're going to get going with the baler, and we're going to put that little Renault tractor onto the baler. I used to actually drive an International. It was a 65 horsepower International tractor, and we would run that one with... Right, if I hop out a second, I'm going to want to unhitch that one there. And then I want to unhitch this body as well, like that. And I'm going to leave both of those there. Should just be able to drive straight out from under them. Perfect. Yeah, so it was a 65 horsepower. It might have been 70. I'm certain that it was 65 horsepower. And that one, it was an International tractor, and that one used to run our baler. Now, I parked up those tractors there last time, and I was thinking to get cultivators or something like that for them. I'm not going to worry about that now. We've got lots of drilling to do, really. But again, I'm not going to worry about it because we are stopping the map this week. So we're sort of going to pick and choose a few jobs that we haven't done before so that we can see what it's like. But it's going to be a bit of mix and match again, obviously, as we're finishing up. This is finishing up a little earlier than I'd originally planned. I was thinking that we'd be running this a little bit longer than this. That's all right. Because I think the higher hills one, I think you're going to like it. I like it. It's a very small map. It's very small fields. It's more compact than this one. But it's modern machinery and stuff. There's no traffic on the road. It was a map that was in FS 2011, apparently, and someone has updated it for 15. So it's quite a bit of work gone into it over the years. And right, where do we want? Oh, we want to go to here. If I just bring up that one a second, back up. Right, refill the sprayer. I have still not been able to find out what area limitation is. No idea what that is. It's something to do with a mod somewhere. But yeah, again, I really don't know which one it is or what it's all about. So one day I might find that out, but I'm not all that concerned. We've only got a few weeks left. It doesn't seem to have affected me as I've been playing the map or any of the maps. So once we get on to our new game in, it's now 9 weeks. I'll have to do a weekly counter. I will figure it out before the next episode and we can start doing a weekly counter. Now, how is this one going to perform with spraying? So let's unfold it. He's got a nice width on him. He does have a good reach on him. This is a much bigger reach than the spinner has. Right, info, honey, empty. Yes, we do get the notices come up at the top, which is actually pretty good. So let's turn this one on, and then we can start. So I think all we've got to do to turn it on... How do we turn it on? Fold sprayer. Hire worker. Oh, turn on. No. Turn off. Right. Right, there's no... Oh, hang on. Maybe there's a PTO that we've got to connect. That could be it. I have done this before. Yes, there is a PTO that we've got to connect. I don't know where it is. It's in underneath, but we forgot to connect the actual drive. Ah, there we go. Now we have a turn-on sprayer. Right. It does help if you turn the machine on. So how fast does it go when it's spraying? Well, he does get a good rate of knots. Good speed. 12 miles an hour we can go bombing down the field in. Excellent. That's actually really good. I really like this. And it's a wider spread than the fertiliser spinner that we've been using. Now, how I used to do this, because I haven't actually done much in the way of spraying. Oop, that's not quite far enough. When I was playing 2013, I used to spray all of my fields rather than use fertiliser. Or I did to start with. And then I got a small fertiliser spreader that was exactly the same width as my seed drills. And I had 5 seed drills going around the map. I put the hired help on. And I put the hired help going on those. And I would put them with the fertiliser spinner on the front. And the drill on the back. And they go around and they would do the seed and fertiliser all in one go. Which actually worked out really cool. That was it did work very well. I was quite pleased with the results on that one. So let's just stop there and back up again. I know you wouldn't ordinarily spray a field in this manner. You would just drive around the corner. But I'm a rebel. I like to do things differently. Let's come back up here. And while we come down here, we'll see if we can have a look at it from some different angles. And see. I tell you what I would like to do is... Is there any adjustment for it? Ah, you can lift it up and down. I think that's about it. Oop. Straying a little bit there. Right, that was the only adjustments. You can lift it up on the frame. But that does look pretty cool. That does. Oop. Let's see if I can get round the corner looking at it from this angle. Not the easiest task. And it's not using it very fast either. It's not using it ridiculously fast like... some of them do. I know some of the sprayers seem to sort of go through the sprays at a rather high rate, so you're forever running backwards and forwards to fill back up again. But no, this is really, really cool. I'm really liking this. Yeah, that does look very good. We'll try this in cab in a second. Let me just finish up here. And, oop, I'm going to have to turn around like this. So let's try this in cab. What are we like for in cab? Can't see the end of the sprayer. I can see the end of it on that side. But I can't see the end here. The mirrors don't work very well on this one. I think... Right, let's try and just set it up. Right, we do have enough room. We can do the whole thing here in one go, in one pass. So let's come down through again. Just got to keep it reasonably straight. I can see the spray coming off of there. But I can't see the field very well behind me. I'm drifting a little bit here. Just moving over slightly. This is a very, very difficult machine to use from in-cab. Very difficult. Right. I got one tiny little bit there. And if we were going to be staying on this map, we would break out the seed drill now and get this, just sort of finish up this last little bit. Right, there we go. Yeah, we would break out the seed drill and we would start sowing this field. And this one was the potatoes, wasn't it? I think we would do wheat in this field. That would be the next for this field. Right. 2,300. I've cultivated one field. We've ploughed all the fields, and I've cultivated one field down here. And then I've got the kirovits working on the old sugar beet field. The field that we had maize in over here, this is the one that has been cultivated. So I'm going to come down here, and we're going to spray this one. He missed a little bit of a slice there. Oh, no, that's old fertiliser. Now, has the he's still going, he's still going. Look at him over there. Yeah, he's doing a grand job. And there's the plough over on the side. So let me just unfold a minute. And we will start spraying this field. In our next episode, we will do the baling. I will get the baler onto that Renault tractor. And we will do some baling. So we got the small bales. And when you put hay straight in for... Oh, no, I don't want to do it on auto, do I? I want to just do it like that. When you put hay in for cattle, and it's not part of mixed feed, it actually just sort of transforms back into grass. And that's okay, because what I thought we would do is just to test how we could put the bales in, was make the do the bales, gather them up and put them back in the yard, and then get the bucket onto the Volvo, and... put the bucket onto the Volvo, and then once we've done that, scoop up some of the bales and just tip them into the trough. Or we might actually have... Well, I don't know if that would work, actually. Don't think it does. I think we'll have to scoop them up, put them into a mixer wagon, and tip them from there into the trough. And that will basically be counted as grass rather than hay, because you can't feed just straight hay in this game. It's a bit of a shame. I think it would be good if you could. Maybe for like feeding the sheep, you've got to give them hay and grass. Actually, that would be really cool, wouldn't it? If you had to feed your sheep both hay and grass in order for them to like get the 100%. I mean, obviously, you wouldn't have to ever do that, but it would kind of represent that you do actually have to feed hay to your sheep in the winter, because there isn't enough for them to eat just on plain grass. Sometimes you can have enough, depending where you live. But very often you do actually have to feed hay to your sheep. Get them through the winter months. We are running out of time. This is going to be a bit of a short episode. Well, not too short, I wouldn't have thought. But with Sandy Bay, the last two episodes have actually run over quite a bit. And I didn't actually mean for them to go over that much. But we got kind of caught up with the Octa Quad and a few other bits and pieces that we've been doing. And yeah, it just kind of happened. It wasn't intentional, but it did happen. So, this one will be a little bit shorter than that. Let me just back up a little bit there. There we go. Right, so when I start my next map, my Higher Hills map, do you want me to start the game with 100, 150, or £200,000? I'm starting off with some cows. I've got a few bits of machinery and everything all ready to go. It's sort of giving myself a head start so we don't have 20 episodes of me just desperately trying to scrape together some money so that we can do the different tasks. I think it will work out quite nicely like this, but it's sort of up to you how much money you want me to start with. So 100, 150, or £200,000. Head down below into the comment section. Let me know your thoughts. It's your vote. It's your game. Now, we've got a little bit left on this field. I'm going to do a second round on this one, and then we can sort of just move up and down the last little bit, just doing the headland. That Kirovitz has almost finished that field. We won't worry about doing any more spraying after this, and I'm not going to worry too much about using Kirovitz either. Oops. No, don't hit the tree! Ooh, did you see that? Oh, I got too keen. I was just too eager then. That is not the way you treat your sprayer. That would have smashed the boom right off. We wouldn't be spraying right now, ladies and gentlemen, if this was anything like real life. No, right now we would be weeping because we've just smashed our boom. And if you do it like that, smash it up like that, before you can work on it, you've actually got to clean the whole thing and flush out all of this chemical that we're spraying onto the field. It's not a good idea to get that stuff on your skin. So if you've just smashed your boom off in the middle of spraying, you've got a big cleanup operation before you can do anything else. I'm going too fast, aren't I? I'm going much too fast when I finish at the end of each line. All right. I will finish up this field, and I may not even show you the field before we finish the series. So tomorrow we're doing baling. Oops, turn it off. Tomorrow we're doing baling, and we'll gather up some bales, and I'm not quite sure what we're going to do in our final episode. We do have a huge mountain of eggs, so we will drive to the village and we will sell those. I think what we might do as well is get another tanker full of milk, and we will drive that from the yard at the top, and we will take that to the actual milk sell point, which is right at the other end of the map. And we haven't actually been over there yet. So there's one little place that I want to show you before we finish. And I'm not quite certain what else we're going to do before I finally say fare thee well to old times. And I have really enjoyed playing this map. So if you've enjoyed this episode, please head down below and give us a like. And if you really enjoyed it, please tell your friends all about me. Get them to come and watch as well. That would be awesome. But until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.